In this video, we're going to look at a couple examples of solving linear equations that have the variable on both sides. So in our first example, we have 3 minus 11x equals 3x plus 4. The first thing we're going to want to do is combine like terms. So we want to get all the terms with x on the same side and all the terms without x on the other side. So, for instance, we may decide to add 11x to both sides, because that'll get rid of it on this side and move it over to this side. And that gives us 14x on the right-hand side. Since we put the x's on this side, let's put the terms without x on the left-hand side. So we're going to subtract 4 from both sides. So we have negative 1 equals 14x. Last step in solving, divide both sides by 14, and we have x equals negative 1 over 14. In our second example, we have to do a little bit of work before we start getting everything on the same side. First thing we're going to want to do is get rid of those parentheses so we can move things around easily. So first thing, let's distribute the 5 to both the x and the 2. So that gives us 5x minus 10 plus 4. And we'll combine that in the next step. Now we'll distribute the negative 3 to the x and the 4. So that gives us negative 3x minus 12 plus x. Now, let's see what we can combine on each side, and then we'll think about moving things around. Now here, there's only a 1x term on the left-hand side, so 5x minus 10 plus 4 gives us minus 6. Over here, we can combine the x terms. Minus 3x plus x gives us minus 2x. Nothing to combine with the 12 is minus 12. And now we're in a similar situation to problem A. Let's get the x terms all on the same side. So I'm going to move the negative 2x, I'm going to move over here by adding 2x to both sides. We could go the other direction. We'd get the same answer. So it's really up to you if you would have wanted to subtract 5x from both sides instead. Now because we put the x's over here, let's put the terms without x on the other side. So add 6 to both sides. This is a negative 6 over here, so we end up with 7x equals negative 6. Divide both sides by 7. Cancels the 7's out here. And that gives us x equals negative 6/7. Which, depending on how you want to write it, you could write the negative on top or on bottom, or just put it out in front of the fraction. Those are all the same thing.